السلام عليكم. This is another case. We're talking about the anatomy of the primary impression. So the student took this impression. She was telling me there's a problem anteriorly. And then we're talking about this fold. Okay, we have some wrinkles here. The wrinkles here are, the material was a bit cold when you entered. Okay, so coldness in the material causes this. Here, this usually comes in the buccal or here. When you are entering, you push the cheek using this area. So when you push the cheek, it's indented. Why? It's not a frenum, it's the cheek while you're going in. But the idea where she's concerned about is the anterior area, actually, and this is what I'm going to concentrate on. First of all, I told her anatomically, I see that this is deeper than this, and this is deeper than this, and we take the measurements, the one we know. I'm going to take the measurements quickly from the patient's mouth. Just, you've seen it in other videos, I'm not going to concentrate on that, but this is correct. Sorry, this one is for this side, this is correct. This is correct, okay? But her concern was in the anterior. So I first of all, I told her compare with the mouth. It's not only the anatomy. The anatomy is saying it's okay, this is deeper than this. That what I see from the tray, that the tray is exposed. Maybe the tray was hitting and you did not. You were too much labial in the tray. But still, I want to see the anatomy. So I'm going to stretch the tissue without the impression. If I turn it, see, I don't have any ridge. So this is the actual anatomy that this patient has. Okay, so this is the difference when I tell you compare with the mouth. So if you're confused, compare with your mouth. Once more, okay? See that ridge? I don't see a ridge at all. The ridge is almost disappeared, okay? I only see a very minimal amount of tissue, okay? This is a different anatomy from this patient. See this patient, this is another patient, another case. See how much ridge he has? Even it's resorbed, but still there is a ridge. But here it's almost wiped away. So this is the anatomy he has. It's not the issue that the tray is hitting. It's the issue is this is the anatomy that he actually has. And those are the patients that we need retention from the lingual pouch from. Okay, these are the very important people to take their lingual pouch correctly. We want the denture to take the retention and the support and the area from here, even if the lingual pouch goes more than the retinal pouch. So what I'm going to tell you, although this is correct, I'm going to tell you, please take more material and go back and fill in this area to take the width of the sulcus, and also maybe record more distally. The lingual sulcus is not like this. The retinal pad, the lingual pouch is deep, is deeper horizontally. So this is a highly resolved case. We need to take as much as possible from the lingual pouch. How do I do that? I'm going to take the excess from material from here, build it here. I know the depth will limit by the tissue because the depth is correct. But what you don't have is the width and the distal extension. So I want to take the lingual pouch as much as possible. So take this excess, build it horizontally, and pick up and repeat on one side, then do the same on the other. See that sulcus is more thick here, this is more correct. But once more, the lingual pouch, this is the retromolar pad, okay? She didn't take the distal part of the lingual pouch. We need this because this is a highly resolved case, okay?